Hello everyone, welcome back to MathMood, my friend. Today, really interesting problem, real quick problem with double factorials. And I want to show you how can we solve it. First of all, we know about 5 factorial. Real quick, 5 factorial equal to 1 times 2 times 3 times 4 and times 5. And a lot of students know that this is equal to 120. But what about double factorials? It is equal to 120 factorial. Of course, it's not correct, because this factorial is not equal to 5 factorial and then this factorial. This is absolutely incorrect. And I record this video for those who don't know about double factorials, and they think that right here we'll have 120 factorials of a huge number. So, for example, we have 7 with double factorial. And what is the rule with this double factorial? We need to go to this 7 only with the parity of this number 7. So, this 7 is odd number. So at first we need to mention what is this number. So 7 is odd number. So 7 with double factorial, we go to this 7 only with odd numbers. So we have 1, then we have 2, we don't need it, we have 3, we don't need 4, we need 5, we don't need 6, we need 7. And this is 7 with double factorial. So we can easily multiply it, we'll have 15 times 7, I guess 105, but doesn't matter. We need 5 with double factorial. So let's go with 5 is double factorial. So we have 5 is double factorial. Firstly, we look with the parity of this 5. 5 is odd number. It can be cannot be divided by 2, so it's odd number. Yeah. And let's go to this 5 with only odd numbers. Let's start with 1 times 2, not times 2. We have 3 and not 4, we have 5. So this product is 5 with double factorial. And don't multiply it, let's plug in this answer, in this final answer. So 5 with double factorial, we'll have 1 times 3 times 5, and 5 with factorial, with 1 factorial, equal to 1 times 2 times 3 times 4 and times 5. I don't want to multiply it because we can easily cancel. Take a look, 1, 1, 3, 3, 5, 5. So the answer is 8. As you can see, real quick, the answer is 8. We just forgot this approach because this is not correct. This is the double factorial problem. I hope you enjoy it. If you do, leave a like, write any comment. It's really important for me and I really appreciate it if you help to improve my content. Thank you for your support. I really appreciate it and see you in the next videos. Have a great day.